Warning! If you are offended by someone being critical of a player on their team, this is not the video for you to watch. So, if you are from the generation of soft fans who eat Tide Pods for breakfast, I suggest you get out of this video while you still can. In the meantime, viewer discretion is advised.
What is going on, guys? This is your host of the most, Philly Jim, coming to you guys with another video. And in this video today, we are going to go over just a few little things that I think Carson Wentz needs to improve on heading into 2020. So before I start, I don't want people to think that I am hating or nitpicking or anything, because people have taken my Joel Embiid criticisms that I have had quite a lot of during this little stretch. The Sixers have been struggling. Please don't take it as I'm hating, because a lot of people have accused me of hating Joel Embiid. No, I just see that this guy can be one of the best players to ever play. He can be one of the best big men to ever play, but he doesn't want to be. So that's what I have a problem with. But a lot of people have taken what I say about him as I'm straight up hating on him. But don't take this video as I'm hating on Carson Wentz, because I love Carson Wentz. I'm a huge Carson Wentz fan. I have been, you know, pretty much since we drafted him. I wanted us to draft him when we traded up over Jared Goff, even though everyone said, oh, well, he didn't play at a Division I school, blah, 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 blah. The guy was way more talented, and he is very talented. So with talent comes a few little criticisms. So we're going to get right into it. So my number one criticism of Carson Wentz is the fumbling. This guy, he's too loose with the football. So at the end of the day, you got to understand when an explosive pass rusher comes off the line, let's say somebody like Khalil Mack or someone comes off the line, you got to understand these dudes are big, strong, and fast. They can get off the edge, get right to you, and then when you're not looking, when you're looking for a man downfield, you know, they can come right behind you and smack that ball out of your hand. So Carson Wentz needs to figure out when a play is over, you just got to tuck it, and sometimes you got to eat it, sometimes you got to throw the ball out of bounds. Him holding the ball too long has led to way too many turnovers. So at the end of the day, Carson's got to do a better job taking care of football. That's the number one problem. Number two, his footwork. I have noticed since 2017 something's different with his footwork. You know, I don't know really how to describe it, but it does not look the same. He was a lot more comfortable with these 3 and 5 step drops in 2017. So he just looked more comfortable in the pocket, and he doesn't look as comfortable in the pocket as he did in 2017. So he's got to
work with Press Taylor and
whatever other offensive coaches, Doug Peterson, Press Taylor, who is going to be the passing game coordinator now. These guys got to work with him on that. They got to tell him when to set his feet, because it's affecting his throws when he kind of sails a ball a little too far. The footwork goes a long way. So I think Carson Wentz needs to work on his footwork. And the third and arguably the most important thing, you could either say the fumbling is the most important, or you could say this is the most important. The guy has to learn
when, it's like I said,
he has to learn when a play's over. So he has to, what I would do if I was Carson Wentz is I would watch film on
other mobile quarterbacks.
I would watch Patrick Mahomes, I would watch Aaron Rodgers,
I would watch Russell Wilson.
These guys all known for their ability to extend plays and make big-time throws. But at the end of the day, one thing these guys have also been able to do is protect themselves. Aaron Rodgers, he knows when to slide. Russell Wilson, he knows when to slide. Mahomes knows when to slide. These guys know when to slide or go out of bounds. Carson Wentz doesn't really do that. He kind of, what's the right way to put it? He just dives head first. And, you know, if you dive head first like that, you're going to take the risk of Jadeveon Clowney throwing his entire body at you and spearing you in the back of the head. So at the end of the day, guy has to learn when plays are over. Guy has to learn to throw the ball out of bounds. Guy has to learn how to slide. Got to learn how to protect the football. Just step out of bounds. If you're going to run the ball, you can run the ball. I encourage Carson Wentz to run the ball because that's part of his game. He is effective when he makes plays with his feet, whether he extends plays or whether he's running for first downs. But if you're going to run for first downs, if you're going to run for extra yards, you don't want to dive head first because you put yourself in a position to where you're probably going to get hurt and things aren't going to end up too well for you. So I just want to see Carson Wentz be able to protect himself. But these are a few things that I think Carson Wentz can improve on and get better at heading into next year. And hopefully he will work on those things and we'll be a better team because of it. So that's all I got to say, guys. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Please go sub up to the Read and React channel. Read and React channel is coming back soon. We're going to be working on some draft stuff and other things as well. So make sure you check that out. This is your most Philly Jim, and I will see you later.